Okay, let's start off by going to the Insert menu. Choose Symbols and Shapes. Now here you have a handful of clip art styles where you can insert images and shapes. They are limited, but a good way to do a bit of practice. We will choose from the stickers. Let's select a globe. Either double click or drag it to the canvas like so. You can then resize with the plus and minus signs, or use the hand to move and position the object. You can also resize with the selection frame that appears around the selected object by holding the mouse on the corner box and dragging accordingly. At any corner with the mouse carefully positioned, you get this small circle and rotation arrow, which allows you to rotate the object. Click anywhere on the canvas to deselect. Let's now add in an arrow. Choose this and then click on the canvas and drag to control the length and direction. Release the mouse and you can use these symbols to adjust the thickness. And then if you use the style option, this will allow you to have some color choices. As you can see, there are three squares on the selected arrow and you can use the middle square to curve the arrow. If you avoid the squares but still click on the arrow, this allows you to easily reposition it. We still have our stickers clip art available on the right, so let's bring in a second image. When no object is selected, but you click in a space on the canvas, you automatically get a text creation box with self-explanatory options. Note that title, subtitle, and body are separate style and font options, and these connect to the settings that are in the themes menu. Fonts can be increased and decreased in size with the A symbols. You have a color control and alignment options. Now, let's group these images with a frame. Choose the style. Drag the mouse around the objects you want to frame. Note you can finite adjust this once it's in place. With the frame selected, all the content within it can be moved as a group using the hand transformation tool. Also, again with the frame selected, you get options to change the frame style. Okay, let's make this simple diagram a short presentation. In Prezi, we say path when we talk about creating views and slides. So let's create a set of views, or you might prefer to think of these as slides. We're going to first right-click on the circle frame and choose Add to Path. See how this appears on the left-hand side. So then select the first image in the frame. Right-click and add this to the path. And follow this through for the arrow and the plane. You can reorder the path on the left. We are going to move the overview image to be our end and final image. Let's see what this looks like in presentation mode.